As soon as my opponent has finished shuffling the playing cards, I take them back, and all I'm going to do is execute a few more shuffles. Now, the secret here is designed to make it look like I'm just shuffling the cards, but while I'm doing this, I'm shifting key cards into the most desirable position. In this case, I'm shuffling all of the queens to the top of the deck, one by one. So right now, there's one more queen left to find. And I think I got her. So now, after those shuffles, I should now have four queens on top of the deck. Hi, I'm Daniel Madison. These are the Madison Sharps playing cards. And this very deck is an M deck, a Madison deck. And in this video, I'm going to demonstrate for you just how powerful and beautiful this deck of cards is. And to show you what can be achieved with this deck, I'm going to do this completely blindfolded. So as I'm making my blindfold out of an old t-shirt, I'll just talk about the deck for a moment. This has been on my mind for a very long time, and it's the answer to a question. How do you solve this problem? A deck of playing cards is thoroughly shuffled by your opponents, by a participant, and you need to be able to find not just a selected playing card, not just any playing card, or should I say not a playing card that has been selected and lost in the deck, and not just any freely named playing card, but how can you always know the position of every single card in the deck after it's been shuffled? And this isn't a marked deck of playing cards. That's something that we'll talk about a little bit later on. That's why I'm wearing a blindfold. There's no markings on this deck. Now, this deck has been expertly cut by the slight surgeon who's helping us create these decks. I need my scissors, Charles. And if you didn't know the secret, this would just be a normal standard deck of playing cards. But for those who know the secret, this is so deadly, so dangerous, and in many ways, it completely removes the need for any sleight of hand whatsoever, because your opponent can thoroughly shuffle the deck of playing cards, and whichever playing card you need, you can find it straight away. Charles, what do you think of my blindfold? So rude. Now, it's important that you know I'm not trying to fool you, right? I'm not trying to fool you watching this video. I can't see the deck. I'm not peeking at anything. It's not a marked deck of cards. And you have to believe me when I tell you that it is a thoroughly shuffled deck of playing cards. And I'll show the deck a few times just so that you can see. There's no stack going on here. And for anybody who thinks there's a stack, I'm going to shuffle the deck a few times face up so that you can see there's no order. I'm being as messy as I can here. The false shuffle theory is completely out of the window right now. I don't know the order of any of these cards, at least not yet. So just to show you, thoroughly shuffle. I don't know any positions of any of the playing cards yet. As soon as the participant's finished shuffling, they hand you the deck back. All it's going to take me is a few shuffles to find any of the playing cards. As soon as my opponent has finished shuffling the playing cards, I take them back, and all I'm going to do is execute a few more shuffles. Now, the secret here is designed to make it look like I'm just shuffling the cards, but while I'm doing this, I'm shifting key cards into the most desirable position. In this case, I'm shuffling all of the queens to the top of the deck, one by one. So right now, there's one more queen left to find. And I think I got her. So now, after those shuffles, I should now have four queens on top of the deck. And of course, I don't need the blindfold. I'm using this to show you that I'm not using a marked deck to achieve this. I'm using something else, something very different. And that's just an example with the queen. So we're gonna run through all of the cards, starting with the ace. After that, once I've gone through each one at a time, we'll just pick a few random cards. Charles is gonna help me find those cards. Charles is gonna help me name those cards, and I will just find them through the deck to show you just how powerful this concept really is. So let's start with the aces, and I'm just gonna go for one ace, and then we'll move straight on to the twos. In fact, we'll work backwards from that. In fact, while I was shuffling, and it's difficult for me to, I have to bite my tongue because I don't wanna give away the secret just yet, but while I'm shuffling, Even without trying, I found two of the aces. So these should be ace and ace. Two red aces, perfectly. So we're gonna work backwards from that. So we're gonna go from king, queen, jack, all the way down, back down to the two, to the ace. And I'll do this with some speed to show you just how easy this is. So let's go for a king. And that's now king on top of the deck. Next, we've got all the queens, so obviously we're gonna skip the queens and we'll go straight for a jack. Jack. And I'm so confident with this that I'm not even gonna check the cards. Next up is a 10. Found the 10, now shuffle it to the top. So that's a 10 on top. And just to show you how versatile this is too, I'm going to find a few of these cards in my hands. So that's now a 9 on top. Next up, something I figured out while I was shuffling, there should be an 8 on the bottom of the deck, but I'm also going to cut to another 8, so that should be 2 8s. 8 and 8. Let's move straight on to the 7s. And the reason I don't have to check 2 is because, well, again, something that I can't really tell you about without spoiling the secret, there's a 7. Let's go for the 6s, not just one 6, because I found this early when we were looking for the 8s, but I can cut straight to 2 more 6s. So that's 6, 6, 6. Let's now go for the 5s. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, follow this up with a 4. Should be a 4. Did that fall off the table, Charlie? Oh no, I hit my glasses. Okay, 4. Again, follow this up with a 4. Should be a 4. Did that fall off the table, Charlie? And just to show you something different with the 3, something interesting, and you can do this with any of the cards. One of the 3s is at position 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That should be a 3. Was it a 3, Charles? 3 of hearts. Perfect. Now the 2s are relatively difficult to find, but if I explain that, then I have to explain why, and I kind of give away a secret a little bit. So I did something else with the 2s, a different way of finding them, which still looks like the same thing. So again, just shuffling the playing cards, and I should now have a 2 on the bottom of the deck. Now you saw, well, this is why I wore the shades. Now you saw how easy that was to find each one of those, and in some cases, it wasn't necessarily luck, but in the shuffles, I discovered 2 at a time. Like the 6s were a naturally occurring thing that happened during the shuffle, during the finding process, and the same with those 8s. Now, I can find any 4 of a kind that's named by a participant if I want those 4 of a kind for my hand, if I'm cheating at a card game. And of course, I can find in this deck, in this thoroughly shuffled deck of playing cards, any freely named playing card, any playing card that I want to find. And just to demonstrate that, let's go for 2 important playing cards. Let's go for the King of Diamonds and the 9 of Clubs. And just to show you where they are, hold on, I have 2 King of Diamonds in this deck, so I'll remove one just so you can see where they are first. So King of Diamonds here, 9 of Clubs right here, right? So there's no control, there's zero control. And it doesn't matter that I know where they are at this point, because I'm going to thoroughly shuffle the playing cards in a way that I'm not going to follow those playing cards. This is a genuine shuffle. So those 2 playing cards are clearly mixed into the deck, and I'm going to look away while I show you too that they're still in there. So take a moment to check that they're still in there in random positions. Now I'm going to close the deck, and I'm going to find those 2 cards, so the King of Diamonds and the 9 of Clubs. And you know, me looking at the deck while I'm shuffling, it's never a good idea with sleight of hand techniques, but it really does make no difference when you're finding these cards. It does change a little bit when you have to find specific playing cards like the ones I'm looking for now. A few things do change, like that. So I've got the 9 of Clubs, and just for fun, we're gonna get the King of Diamonds as well. At the same time, I'm gonna bring that up to the surface with the 9 of Clubs. And hopefully, from your point of view, this just looks like what it is. It looks like I'm shuffling playing cards and then cutting playing cards. So if I've done this right, I've got a 9 of Clubs, a little bit of a hiccup there, a 9 of Clubs and a King of Diamonds. One's on top, one's on the bottom. So the top card, nine of clubs, meaning the king of diamonds should be on the bottom of the deck. There's a strange, I really have to bite my tongue. There's a lot of things I want to tell you about this deck, but I have to bite my tongue. But anybody who picks up an M deck from my website, madison.cards, I'm going to be working on a masterclass very soon, teaching you everything you need to know about this deck. But it really is as easy as I'm making it look. Like, the sleight of hand element has almost been removed, because all you have to do is shuffle the playing cards. And while you're shuffling the playing cards, as long as you know what to do, you are finding those playing cards. You can find four of a kind really quickly, have somebody freely name any playing card, and you can find it within a few moments of simply shuffling the playing cards, either on the surface or in the hands. You can do all of this in the hands without the deck ever having to touch the surface, and it just looks like you're shuffling the playing cards. And in those simple, very natural things to do with the deck of playing cards, you're finding the desired playing cards. Now, another thing to do with this deck of playing cards, even though it is not a marked deck of playing cards, I'm going to take a few random playing cards out. Just imagine the power of this card game. So I have no idea the order of this deck, and I'm going to take random playing cards out. I'm not even going to look when I take them out. So 1, 2, 3, 4, let's get another random one. So 5. And I can tell straight away which playing cards these are without studying these cards. I'm intentionally trying to look away so you know I'm not staring at these cards. These are not marked cards, but I can tell you this is a jack. I can tell you this is an ace. I can tell you that I've got a 10, a 10, and an 8. 10, 10, and 8. So even across the table, if you're playing a card game and someone's holding the cards, you're gonna be able to tell which cards they're holding. The cards that are on the surface, discards, a card that's been selected from the deck. You can even tell cards on top of the deck, and somewhere, sometimes, when somebody else is holding the playing cards, when somebody else is shuffling, you are able to see some of the playing cards. This, I can't stipulate this enough, this is not a marking system. This is the M deck, the Madison deck. These are available at madison.cards right now, not just in the Sharps playing cards, neither in my other playing cards too. And I will say, of all the decks that are at my website right now, so you can get the standard Sharps, which is obviously just the standard deck of playing cards. You can get the F deck, which is a fine stripper deck. Now, the other one after above that is an N deck, so negative stripper, and then we have the M deck. If you have no experience with these decks, this deck, the M deck, is, I don't like the word expert, but you would certainly help yourself if you started with the fine stripper deck, then the negative stripper deck, and then move on to the M deck, move on to this. You do need to have a little bit of skill. However, the deck that pretty much does everything for you, as long as you know how to do a few table shuffles, as long as you know how to do a few. If you can cut the deck, if you can shuffle the deck, then you should be able to do this. It is not necessarily as easy as I'm making it look. But after a little bit of practice, and with my help in the workshops that are going to come along with these decks, then you'll be able to master this deck in moments. Can't, like, because this deck is next to a fine stripper and a negative stripper, this isn't a stripper deck, right? I'm not going to strip playing cards out like this and tell you what they are. That's not what's going on here. Something far more intricate. And just to end this video with one more demonstration with the deck face up, I want you to look where the queens are. I'm gonna look two at this point. I'm in the blindfold. You can do this with blindfold, but I'm gonna look two. And I'm gonna partially explain what's happening. So you can see queen of spades, queen of diamonds, queen of hearts, queen of clubs, right? So I know roughly the position. I hand the playing cards over to my opponent to shuffle. They thoroughly shuffle the cards, then they hand the cards back to me on the table. They wouldn't be face up. I'm doing this face up to show you something. I'm now gonna move those queens to the top of the deck, or the bottom of the deck in this case, so that you can see them. So the first queen is in two cuts. 1, 2, the queen of hearts. The next queen I'll try and get in one cut, and I'll show you how you hide it in the action of shuffling the playing cards. So when you're shuffling, you cut a stack to the side and then you shuffle them together. And now you can see how the coin made it to the top of the deck in one simple action. Now I'll do that again with another coin so that you can see how I can shift two in simply two shuffles. So that was one shuffle. One more shuffle and I can bring the queen of spades also to the top with the queen of clubs. Two queens now on top in two simple shuffles. And I'm going to attempt to get the third queen, the queen of diamonds. We already have the queen of hearts. So if I straighten up, if I go for two cuts first so that I can better hide this, like firstly, when I do the first cut, like I now know where the other queen is from that simple action of cutting the deck and then shuffling together. I didn't control it, I just now know the location so that when I wanna find it and when I wanna pull it out, I can get it in one cut and then shuffle it to the top just like this. And there we have the queen of diamonds. So now it's just a case of shuffling to the top, which means I've shuffled all three queens to the top of the deck or the bottom of the deck, hidden in the simple action of shuffling the playing cards. You don't need me to tell you all the wonderful miracles that can be achieved with this idea, the ability to find any playing card in a thoroughly shuffled deck of cards. But if you do want to master this deck along with me, head over to the Sleight Club. I'll be sharing that masterclass, that workshop very soon. It'll also be at madison.cards. And I'll be doing the same for the F deck and the N deck. And of course, if you don't want these special decks cut professionally by the Sleight Surgeon, then you can just get the Madison Sharps to commemorate and celebrate the opening of my new studio, which I'll show you more of soon, the Madison Casino. I'm Donnie Madison. These are the Madison Sharps. Mad love.